We thank you, scandalous God, for giving yourself to the world, not in the strong and the powerful, but in a baby's weakness. We thank you for offering at our journey's end a new beginning, and for setting in the poverty of a stable the richest jewel of your crown. We thank you for leading us towards Bethlehem, where the empty are filled, the full are emptied, and the poor find riches. Today, find room here and be born amongst us this Christmastide. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. Amen.
On the eighth day, when it was time to circumcise the child, he was named Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he was conceived. When the time came for the purification rites required by the law of Moses, Joseph and Mary took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying,
Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace.
Depart in peace.
The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Penuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was very old. She had lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and then was a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day, fasting and praying. Coming up to them at that very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. When Joseph and Mary had done everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee to their own town of Nazareth. and the child grew and became strong. He was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was on him.
Today, we ask God for a good Christmas, for us and for all the peoples of the earth. We ask that no powerful nation should ever unjustly tax the poor, nor uproot them from their homes. We ask that no unmarried mother should ever be put away in disgrace. We ask that no door will ever be shut upon those who need to find it open. We ask that barbed wire and angry soldiers will not be found in Bethlehem. We ask that wise men and women and young people may be found in all the troubled places of our world. We ask that children may be preserved from all who would hurt them or harm them. We ask that all the nations of the world may offer hospitality to those who flee from danger and seek asylum. And we ask that mothers who weep for their disappeared children may find healing and comfort. Gracious God, in your motherly heart, embrace those for whom we offer our prayers today, for we offer them in the name of Jesus Christ, our vulnerable infant Lord. Amen. the joy of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Mary and Joseph, and the peace of the Christ child be with you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and with all the peoples of the world this Christmas time and forevermore. Amen.